The Philippine government launches its new COVID vaccination drive. The health department says the Pinaslakas program will focus more on improving booster uptake to increase the immunity of those who've already been vaccinated. It aims to administer the first booster shot to at least 50% of the eligible population and fully vaccinate 90% of senior citizens. The DOH is confident it can hit its target of 23 million vaccinees in the first 100 days of the Marcos administration.
Marami na rin tayo nakausap no, na local governments, and actually, sabi nga nila, hindi nyo na nga kailangan magkampanya pa dahil ginagawa naman natin. Kailangan lang talaga pag-igtingin, kailangan lang talaga minsan kalampagin, ano, tsaka para magkatulong-tulong tayo lahat.
Makakapaghanap buhay po tayong lahat ng mas ligtas na may bawas na pangamba, magiging mas ligtas ang pagbabalik eskwela ng ating mga anak, manunumbalik po ang turismo at mababawasan po ang pangamba sa paggamit ng public transportation.
The Philippines expands its rollout of second COVID-19 booster shots. The health department says adults 50 years old and above and individuals aged 18 to 49 who have comorbidities may now receive a fourth jab, but only using the Pfizer or Moderna vaccines. They are also only allowed to get a second booster dose 4 months after receiving their first one. Previously, only health workers, senior citizens, and immunocompromised individuals were eligible. Medical certificates will not be required to avail of the second booster. According to the DOH guidelines, a medical screener or doctor at the vaccination site is authorized to assess and make the determination. The start of the booster drive comes as the Philippines logs another 2,360 COVID-19 cases. This brings the number of active infections to more than 27,000, the highest since April 10. Based on Health Department's latest projections, daily cases may reach 19,000 by the end of August. But it could slow down to between 6,000 and 8,000 if vaccination and booster rates are improved.
If we observe right now, our cases are continuously increasing, but in spite of the continuous increase in the number of cases here in the country, we are seeing that the severe and critical cases are plateauing, meaning it's not going or it's not increasing, and our hospital admissions are not also increasing. Though there are areas in the country right now that we are closely monitoring because we are having increase in the number of admissions, but upon checking and upon analysis, we are seeing that because the admissions are because they have low number of beds that had been allocated for COVID-19.
President Marcos's call for the return of the Reserve Officers Training Corps, ROTC program, backed by the Armed Forces of the Philippines and the Defense Department. The AFP believes the program will instill discipline among the youth and preparedness against all threats. The DND says it can also help educate them about disaster response. But a security expert believes reimposing the program violates international laws on child protection.
Minors to undergo military basic training. Of course, not all of our students have that intention to become military soldiers. We have to adhere to the Universal Human Rights on this. If we think that it violates the rights of the minors and students, then let's not force them to urge them to be trained under the ROTC. Then patriotism, nationalism should be embedded in our education and not through basic military training.
The ROTC became optional in 2002 following the death of University of Santo Tomas student Mark Wilson Chua. He was killed by senior officers for exposing alleged corruption in the university's ROTC unit.
The Philippine Anti-Graft Court upholds its dismissal of a civil suit against the family of the late President Ferdinand Marcos Sr. The decision penned by Sandigan Bayan 4th Division Chair Justice Alex Quiroz cited a lack of evidence against the Marcoses. The case involved some 200 billion pesos in assets and properties, which the government says were illegally accumulated. Justice Quiroz was chosen last week by President Marcos Jr. to lead an agency that oversees government-owned or controlled corporations. Philippine law prohibits the appointment of members of the courts to any agency with quasi judicial or administrative functions. Quiroz is due to retire in 2027, but his camp says he will avail of optional retirement.